church home.
That's where I am from.
That's where I'm from.
That's where I am from. I am from Hopewell.
Let's go to church.
Hopewell. Hopewell.
Calling Hopewell.
Hopewell. Hopewell.
Do you know about it?
Hopewell.
Have you seen it?
Hopewell.
Have you been there?
Hopewell.
Jesus is waiting.
Hopewell.
He met me
Hopewell.
At Hopewell.
Hopewell.
In Collin, Mississippi.
Hopewell.
Upon me, O God.
All right.
According to thy loving kindness, according to the multitude of thy tender mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquities and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgression, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee, thee only, have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight. Thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. I read for you six verses from Psalms 51.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We should join me in singing hymn number 339. I love the Lord, He heard my cry. Yeah. Jesus, Father, we come this evening. Bow down here, humble heart.
Yes, sir.
We come, Father, in those manner that we know how.
Yes.
Father, we come thanking you, Father, for our laying down last night.
Uh-huh.
And our word arriving this morning. Father, Lord, it was you, Father, that touched us this morning. Waking us up to a brand new day. A day that we never saw before. And when this day is gone, we'll never see it again. Father, we thank you, Father, for watching over that we slept and slumbered. Keep us safe from all harm, hurt, and danger. Father, we thank you, Father, for just being so good to us. Father, you've been mighty good to us. You've been better than us, Father, than we've been to ourselves. Father, thank you. Thank you, Father, for your darling son, Jesus, who died on no Calvary cross. And we might have a right to the tree of life. And now, Father, you are the master. You sit high, you look low. And Father, you know all of our needs. Father, we need you right now. Father, we need you, and we can't do without you. Father, some of us need you for one thing, some need you for another. But Father, we all need you as a Savior. And we ask, Father, you save now. Save now from the uttermost to the utmost. And Father, we ask, Father, you please have mercy on us. Because Father, we know that we've been bad children to a good Father. Father, we did some things that we shouldn't have done. We went to some places that we shouldn't have went. But Father, we ask you, Father, look beyond our faults and see our need. Father, we need you. Father, we come and see you. Ask you, Father, to keep our minds staying on Jesus. And keep our eyes looking to the hill which comes out of him. Because all of our help comes from you, Lord. And we ask, Father, to see that you bless the one who's going to bring the message. Father, we ask you to heal this man. Say the Lord. Father, we ask you to bless the sick and the sinner in this evening. And we ask you to bless the bereaved family anywhere in that time of bereavement. And Father, we come to see that the Father, if you will, please forgive the Bible, see the transgression and forgive you, known and unknown. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
There's a little in the valley,
you know Jesus is in the valley.
We appreciate your support as we renew and revive our spirits and our minds. You're welcome to sing, you're welcome to praise, you're welcome to take part in this service, and wherever, which direction the Lord may lead you, you're welcome, welcome, welcome.
shall continually be in my mind. I will bless his name because he's saving grace. And that's why I give him all the praise.
man of God, if you have robbed me, if you say, well, you have who robbed me, and times and all, you're cursed with a curse, if you have robbed me, you will be called me. Now we got a third chapter, 37 and 8.
Amen. Amen.
To this side, please stand, march around. This side, please stand, march around.
Thank you. Since last week.
All right, amen. All right.
Amen. And I can say it again.
Amen.
Right. But we're here in the presence of the Lord to celebrate Jesus.
Yes, sir.
And be revived.
Amen.
And the revival has been getting higher and higher.
Yes, Lord.
Every evening. And we expect no less this evening.
Amen.
But right now, I want to ask if there are any other choirs other than and Hopewell.
Tonight we have, I'm going to call all of them out that I haven't missed. We have Hopewell Baptist Church, Collin, Mississippi. West Point Baptist Church, Hattiesburg. I have a little, just on the members just here. She's going to sing. Pembroke Rock Baptist Church, Hattiesburg, Mississippi. We have some members from the Sweet Pilgrim Baptist Church, Hattiesburg. Friendship Baptist Church, Hattiesburg. So we have Brother Turner, Mount Zion Baptist Church, and Greater Mount Zion Baptist Church. Pembroke. And I think we're asking Reverend Pryor when you get in there to sing the solo. And we have Gloria Mulligan, Church of God and Pride, off of Poole Hill. She'll sing a solo. Right. If there anyone else that want to represent the church that I don't have on the list, I won't say anything in the song.
You got two solos. Well, are there any other choirs from the other churches or represented? Amen. Come on, Sister Glory. Bless.
Amen.
God bless y'all. I thank God for being here tonight.
Amen.
To be in this service tonight. Amen. How many of us are thankful to be alive today? Amen.
Yes,
amen. I know that we go day to day, we live our life, but sometimes it's just a simple thank you that the Lord was wanting from us. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I thank God for being today. Amen. Y'all pray for me. Amen. I'm going to sing this song. Get out your way.
Amen.
All right, Jericho, come here.
We're grateful to have some of the great Mount Zion. Just wave your hand.
All right.
I'm digging in this wife. All right. Amen. From the tribes here. Amen. Amen. We thank God for Pastor. Morning to Reverend Newton. Amen. To the other preachers. Amen. And Pastor, that given chance, he had no wind. Amen.
Shake somebody's hand and tell them to Hope well.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Valores. That's the dear man.
All right.
That's now home.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Bringing you greetings from Hopewell, Pastor Roger Posey. Located in Collins, Mississippi, so I'm calling it on the ridge. We kind of call it hot coffee.
All right, all right.
We invite you to join us. April 30th through May the 1st. As we come in our spring revival, our guest speaker for the 3 days will be Reverend Demetrius Fountain, who, by the way, is myself. You all will love to hear it. Services start at 7:30.
All right.
You all probably know this old song, so just join in and help us out. Trouble in my way.
Jesus.
fix it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All of us that have tried to see what you can do, we can testify today.
Yeah, I know you fix it.
My brother used to say, you can't make me doubt.
All right.
Yeah. I know too much about you.
Yes, sir.
Done too much for
me. All right. Yeah.
Things that nobody else can do.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yes.
Are there any other representatives? Well, I'm the bearer of some good news.
All right.
All right. All right.
Let's see, brother.
I love Satan.
All right. All right. All right. All right.
Yeah. But the Bible says that faith. Coming by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Yes.
So the best is yet to come.
Yes.
So we're going to prepare our hearts for the word, and we're going to let Pastor Newton come in the way that he wants to. He's been blessing us. He said amazing grace, so that's the way we're going to go. He's been blessing us these last 2 days, and we're just going to go high. In Jesus, let it come in his own way. What's great?
been good to you, say amen. Absolutely. If he made a way for you, say amen. Let me ask you something. Has he done anything for you lately? Don't you just give him a hand clap of praise. Truly our God is great, and he's great to be praised. I said that he's greatly to be praised.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Somebody still didn't get it. I said that he's greatly to be praised. The Bible says that the redeemed of the Lord ought to say so. Amen. Oops, another day's journey.
Yes, sir.
And I'm glad about it.
Yes, sir.
The Lord has been so gracious in the dispersing of his divine privileges that he has allowed us together. Not because we've been so good, but because we've done everything right. But again tonight, God's grace is sufficient. Did you hear what I said? And his mercy is everlasting. And his truth endureth for how long? What a mighty God we serve. Amen. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God that we serve. We honor tonight the angel of the church. Amen, Pastor Jordan. Let me thank you again. Just allowing us to come and share. It's been a long time since I've been so close to my house that I could walk to church. Even though I did that, still, amen, I count it a blessing.
Yes, sir.
From Almighty God. We thank God for all these other pastors and preachers. Amen. Pastor Fairley, amen. I'm going to bless God for him too, and all these other ministers that have joined us. Our own Reverend Kelly and Reverend Jordan, amen, is back with us. We praise God for them, to their officers of this church, visiting officers of the various churches, and to the remainder of you, these many members, visitors, and friends, the Lord is blessing us right now.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, Sister Newton in the house.
All right. Amen. Amen. All right. Yes, sir.
We thank God for her. Amen.
Amen.
She's been busy these last couple of days.
Yes, sir.
People that filed their taxes late that's got to pay. Wait till the last minute. Amen.
That's right.
Somebody waved two hands. I understand. I am a little grateful to see all of you. It has truly been a blessing to be here these nights with you.
Amen.
Our prayer is that you've been blessed by God and not impressed by us. My daughter, my grandson, and her fiance is back tonight. Raise your hand.
All right.
Amen. Reverend Keegan. Amen.
Amen.
Grandson, amen. We thank God for all of you. Here's another word from the Lord. I just want to share with you. If I don't key up in hoop that won't bother y'all.
Preach, brother.
Amen. But I just want to share that the word that the Lord laid upon my heart, and I believe the word says that he that had an ear, let him hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. Galatians chapter 6, beginning at verse 1. As a matter of fact, I think that's all I need. Yes, I preached too long because verse 1 is loaded.
All right.
As a matter of fact, you can preach a whole week.
Yeah.
Just from verse 1.
Yeah.
Galatians chapter 6. Verse 1. Reading tonight from the New King James Version. These words are something similar written therein, depending on the translations of the Bible that you have. Brethren, if a man is overtaken in a fault, or in any trespass, you who are spiritual,
Lord have mercy,
restore such a one in a spirit of meekness or gentleness. You see that, don't you? Considering yourself, lest you also be tempted.
All right.
Lord have mercy. I want to talk just a little while tonight from this subject or a theme of ornament. It could have been me. Somebody missed it.
All right.
And the only way that you don't get this tonight, that's because you're trying to find somebody else in it.
All right.
I'm not trying to be nosy. I'm not trying to pry the business, but I want to start by asking a question, and that question is, have you ever messed up?
Yes, sir. You're in the right house.
Let's see, maybe that went over somebody. Have you ever done wrong?
Yes, sir.
I know.
Yes, sir.
Let's see, maybe I can. Have you ever come short of the glory of God? See, I need to talk to some real folk that didn't leave heaven tonight.
All right. And
came. Now listen to me. I heard what you, and I'm glad you were honest.
Yeah.
Because the record says in Romans 3:23 that all have sinned and come what?
Sure.
Of the glory of God. So at one time or another, prior to salvation, we all was torn from the floor.
Yes, sir.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. And if the truth be told, at one time or another, all of us have had some junk in our trunks. Y'all ain't talking back to me. But now I'm getting ready to mess you up now, because I need to ask you something.
All right.
So since you've been saved.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. And sanctified. And filled with the precious Holy Ghost. Have you made any mistakes? Let me go ahead and raise it. I don't want you to think you isolated now. Because if the truth be told from the pulpit, through out the back door, all of us, even since we've been saved, have lived a perfect life. I wish I could point my fingers at you. I need to get my brother on to help me preach this today. He said, because when I point now, when you look at the position of your finger, talking about those that are self-righteous, that's always pointing at somebody else, you've got to understand that there are more fingers pointing back at you than it is what you're pointing at somebody else. Yes. Hear the text tonight. Let me work the text, and I promise you, I'm not gonna hold you long. But the Apostle Paul, who has been purported to be the dominant writer in the New Testament, writes this word because he shares, and I believe that the intentions was to humble some self-righteous folks.
That's right. All right.
You know, there are those of us that feel like God has given us the assignment to be spiritual police. Y'all ain't talking about it. We walk around with our spiritual camcorder. But C-Spy and all these other mobile phone services has helped us out, because now we'll get you with our phone. And we walk around trying to catch folk. Come on, talk back to me. We're trying to catch folk doing something. Y'all ain't talking back to me. And the reason why many of us want to catch somebody else doing something, because we feel that'll take the pressure off of us. So Paul says, and I want you to watch the text, watch the language. He says, because this first word that he uses, the word brethren. Brethren. Now let me go ahead and let you in on a little secret.
Right.
He is talking to saints.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. That's right.
Yes.
Yeah. Amen. All
right. Come on, talk back to me.
All right.
I have biological. Relative.
Yeah, all right.
Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Yeah.
They're not my spiritual brothers and sisters.
All right.
Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Yes, sir.
I hear folks saying all the time, blood thicker than water. But let me go ahead and let you in on a little secret. The only thing that was able to wash away my sin. Was nothing but the blood of Jesus. So when he says brethren, he's talking to those from a fellowship of believers.
Yes, sir.
That has something in common. Y'all ain't talking back to me. See, you can't, just because we are here tonight in the same church, in the same room, at the same time, does not necessarily mean we are in fellowship. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Because to be in fellowship with one another, that simply implies that all of us have got to have something in common. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Because if you ain't been born again, you are still walking around in darkness, and light and darkness don't have any fellowship. As a matter of fact, if you turn these lights out, it's going to get dark up in here. But when you shine the light, y'all ain't talking back to me. As a matter of fact, it does not even have to be a big bulb. But when the light comes on, darkness gotta flee. Are you listening to me? So Paul says tonight, he establishes the fact, amen, that you walk around there thinking you all of that in a bag of Doritos. Brethren, if the word if does not mean what we think it means.
All right. That's right.
Here in from the Greek vernacular, the word if simply means we. So if I can word this like it really is, brethren, we. Not if.
Right.
Yeah.
Not if. Not a probability.
Yeah.
Because when you sitting up in here talking about the never behind you, me. Y'all ain't talking back to me. I hope that's not your testimony that the devil never bothers you, because if he ain't messing with you, he's already got you. Y'all ain't talking back to me. I'm gonna tell you, he bothers me. He tried me on the job. Y'all ain't talking back to me. And then even some Sunday morning, he tried me in the church.
Yes, sir.
But if you resist him,
yeah.
Bible said he'll flee.
Yeah.
If you shine the light,
yeah.
Darkness flees. Brethren, when a man is overtaken in a fall, he's overtaken in a fall. Now, the word overtaken does not imply that he was walking and tripped over something and stopped. It does not depict that of a mishap. But the word overtaken depicts that of a weakness. That's the reason why you got the mind. The company you keep. Y'all ain't talking back to me. If you're trying your best, and you've gone to AA and Alcoholics Anonymous, and you're trying to work on that drinking habit, it ain't good for you after you finish it to hang around folk that's drinking. Come on, talk back to me. Because if you're not careful, you're in will shape you rather than you shaping your environment. Y'all ain't talking that to me. When the proud man is overtaken in a fall, when he errs, he stumbles, or he get weak, and it happens. It happens. I want you to understand now, when we look at this word, at the word man, that does not necessarily mean it's talking about the male gender.
Amen.
But it's talking about all human. So when you fall, and he made a mistake. When he go through some trying times and fail some tests, everybody don't have any business trying to say anything.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yeah. Blind can't lead. Y'all ain't talking about me. How crazy would it be for me to call up Stevie Wonder or Ray Charles and desire them to drive me on. Y'all ain't talking back here. You asking for trouble. That by accident waiting to happen. I wish I had some help here. And so all I'm saying, that everybody that populate the pew don't have any business trying to address the issue. Because everybody in the church ain't spiritual. And that went over somebody's head. And if you are not spiritual, you're carnal. And a carnal mind cannot obtain spiritual things. Oh, y'all missed that. This is what the carnal mind does. The carnal mind rejoices rather than restores. The carnal mind says, I told you it wasn't that jewel. Doing all that shouting. Singing like a mockingbird. Now look out. Y'all ain't talking back to me. The carnal mind said, I told y'all a long time ago, if you just keep watching him, sooner or later, y'all ain't talking back to me. But what the carnal mind failed to acknowledge, that it could have been you. Y'all ain't talking back to me. A lot of times, and this is always, that's the reason why the incident in John chapter 8 with the woman that was caught in adultery. That bothers me the way that was handled. Several things without the order. First of all, they read part of the scripture. Y'all ain't talking about that. Yes, they did, because the law said that it takes two to tango. Now, if she was caught, century, we catch who we want to catch. We make obey the rules who we want to obey the rules. We make abide by the law who we want to abide. It may be somebody else's daughter that got weak and got pregnant out of wedlock. Don't stick your chest out. Y'all ain't talking that to me. Because that same dog. Oh, this ain't sitting too pretty. Let me hear it. It's the last night. I'm gonna stay here a while. Ye which are spiritual. And you can't be spiritual unless you say.
Amen.
Huh?
Right.
Restore the task is at hand is to restore, not to kick them out. Because you got to realize that the church is an infirmary that is supposed to be. If there's ever a place that spiritual healing ought to take place. It's in the church. And so many of us walking around here. It ain't been to nobody's school calling ourselves doctor. All to be sued for malpractice. With all of these Simpson folk. Y'all ain't gonna be y'all get quiet. With all of these people that are spiritually sitting right before us, and we all we want is the money. Go ahead and do what you want to do. Go ahead and act like you want to act. Go ahead and say what you want to say. But as long as you pay your doctor bill. on, sit down. You which are spiritual. Restore. That's the objective. It's not to rejoice. Don't laugh. Don't laugh. Don't rejoice over somebody else. Mishap. Don't rejoice. Please. Don't go around talking about them, hanging their names. Don't do it because that same devil. Y'all ain't talking about me. That tripped them up. You are not immunized or vaccinated. You have not been immunized or vaccinated from his attack, because if he got him, y'all ain't talking back to me. Somebody else's son got strung out. This week, don't rejoice. Because if it ain't one thing, it's something else. Yours may not be doing what somebody else is doing, but they're doing something. And let me tell you one thing. Many of us, the problem with many of us, and that is the reason why we don't need to be saying anything, because the only difference between us and them is we didn't get caught.
Amen.
Amen. Restore. Well, here's the implication of restore. What do you mean by restore? The word restore depicts that of another Greek word, paratoma, which is in our language an orthopedic type of term, which requires a broken bone requires an orthopedic specialist. I don't need, or you shouldn't have, that merit. Working on a knee replacement. Y'all ain't talking back to me. If I got a problem with my head, I need a neurosurgeon, not a foot doctor. Are y'all getting this?
Yes.
See, there are people in the church that have been gifted to do certain things. And what we need to learn to do is stay in our lane. Y'all ain't talking about that. Some of us think we got all the gifts. I wish I had some help here. But everything, come on, I got it. Y'all ain't helping me here. And an individual that think they possess everything gonna end up not being effective at
nothing.
Restore. So here it is. When you break a bone, you don't need somebody. Let me use the leg for an analogy. You don't need somebody that seesawing. On your leg, they sitting on your leg. It's already broke. You're already in pain. So what you need somebody, and that is somebody that has the ability and skills enough and the heart to administer, first of all, some TLC.
Amen.
Some tender. Loving. That's what a spiritual person will do, because first of all, a spiritual person realizes, and I thank God for this, a spiritual person realizes, look, I haven't always been saved. I remember when. Y'all ain't talking back to me. And then the next thing they remember, and that was, there was a time when people had to be patient with me. There were times when I know folk got tired of worrying with me, but they stuck with me. But I praise God that somebody, they didn't give up on me. They kept working with me. That's what a spiritual person is, because the goal is to get you back to where you need to be. So we need a proper person, spiritual person. We need a spiritual orthopedic specialist.
Yes, sir.
that knows how to handle. I'm already hurting.
Yes, sir.
I'm already hurting, and number one, I don't need you to tell me that I broke my leg. I know that. As a matter of fact, I knew that before you did. I felt the breath. I wouldn't have come to you if nothing was wrong. Even Jesus said that he that is way needs no physician. So restore such a one. I'm not finished yet. Spirit of meekness. Considering yourself less, here's the kicker. You also be tempted.
Yes, sir.
How do I want you to handle me if it was me? Every time you fall, or every time you make a mistake, I've got to treat you just like I would want you to treat me if it was me. It has nothing to do with what my last name is. How many pews I bought. How many bulbs I put in the chandelier. That has nothing to do with if you got the love of God in your heart and you are spiritual, automatically you are going to restore such a one in a spirit of humbleness. Now watch this. Get back to this lady. They called her and they brought her, but they didn't bring Now I don't know what him was. Or who he was related to. You know, sometimes people get away based on their last name. But I serve a God that knows all. Y'all ain't talking about that. They brought her to the wrong room. Now watch this, because now the Bible, the law did say the individual that was caught, they should be stoned.
That's what it said.
That's what it, and I want to tell you, some folk came to church that day with some rocks. Yes, they did. In their purses, in their socks. Y'all ain't talking back to me. In their choir robe. They didn't come to worship, they came to throw. Brandon, they asked Steve, they told Jesus, Master, this woman was caught in adultery. We called her. How y'all always seeing everything? We caught her with our hands in the cookie jar, in the very act. But then they went on to say, Moses commanded us that such should be stoned. And then say,
what you say back?
Know what Jesus did? He stood down. Didn't say a word. And with his finger, he wrote on the ground. Now some of us try to get smart and come up with what he wrote. I'm not going ever there. I'm not going there tonight because the Bible does not specify. But so I ain't gonna lie on Jesus. But all I know is that he wrote on the ground as though he heard them not. There are some things that you need to let go in one ear. But they wouldn't give up. They wouldn't give up because really they were trying to trap him. Because had he said go ahead and stone them, they would have reported them to the Romans. Because Jews were not permitted to carry out their own execution. If he had said, watch this, leave alone, then they would have said, oh my God, he does not adhere to the law.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. So we got him between the rocks.
Yeah.
If only she standing
there. Yeah.
They got drug up in there, clothes on. Read it. They wouldn't stop at the back of the church with them. They burst in and brought them all the way to the front and slung them down in front of everybody. And they didn't do like they should have been. They should have been privately. What happens to going to somebody privately and telling them they didn't need the whole church? But they continued asking.
Yes, they did.
Up the whole sir.
They continued asking.
Yes, yes.
And finally, Jesus looked up at them and said, "All right, let's get the show on the road." But I tell you what, I know you got your rock. I see you. Matter of fact, I saw you when you picked them up.
Yes.
Let's get the show on the road. But now, but before you throw, I want the one. That has never seen. Y'all never listen to me. To go ahead and cast. You know what I heard? Because they was the ones been throwing the rocks the longest. They trained the young folk to throw. And finally everybody had left, and the one that needed to be there with her was there with her by himself, and that was Jesus. And the woman looked up at him, and Jesus says to her, "Woman, where are those dying accused? Had no man." Could be empty. She said, "No man, Lord." Watch Jesus now. Jesus looked at him and said, "Neither do I condemn." But watch him now. I don't condemn thee, but I don't condone what you did. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Go.
I feel like we
Can you imagine her standing there?
Baffled.
In awe, because she realized that she was guilty. Y'all ain't talking back to me. She realized that capital punishment was in awe. And I can imagine the doc saying, "Lord, you jack. You don't understand. They caught me. I'm guilty. I know I'm here by myself, but I got to hold up for myself. I'm responsible for what my part was." Well, but I understand the capital punishment is in order. But I can imagine Jesus saying, "Let me tell you something. A few days from now, they gonna put an old rugged cloth my show.
Yes, sir.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. They're going to march me up the Via Belarus.
Yes, sir.
Up the way of sorrow.
Uh-huh.
But I'm not doing that because I've seen it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Happy
yes, sir. Yeah.
But I'm doing that for you to see.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Yeah.
And I'm going to hang down from the 6th to the 9th hour.
Yeah.
And I'm going to die now. No man is going to take my life.
Yeah.
But I'm going to lay my life down for my friend.
Yeah.
I wish I had some help here. And you know yourself that anything you lay down, you can pick it up again. I wish I had some help here. Jesus said they're going to nail me to the cross. Now they going to mess up. Because as long as they keep me flat and keep me level to the ground, it's going to be all right. But when they lift me up, I wish I had some help here. They're going to mess up because I told them a few days prior that if I wish I had some help here. He lifted up, I'll drop. I'm wondering if there's anybody up in here that know that Jesus told the truth when he said, I'll draw me unto me. Can I go ahead and tell you, he died. Yes, he did. I don't know about you, but I'm glad that he died. I said, I'm glad that he died. Can I get about 3 people over here that's glad that he died? So look at somebody and tell them, hey, that third day mom. He got up. Yes, he did. With all power in his hand. Is there anybody up in here that know he got up? Is there anybody up in here that know that he got up? You ought to be able to tell from an eye bone that the Lord got up. Because when he rose up in my heart. Somebody say, I looked at my hand, and my hand looked new. But that ain't what happened with me. I looked at my hand, and they looked the same. But when he rose in my heart, the things I used to do, I don't do no more. Somebody say, I looked at my feet, and they did it too. But I still wear a knife. Nothing about my feet changed, but the path I walk in. I wish I had some help here. The places I used to go, I don't go no more. I wonder if anybody can tell him, thank you for saving my soul. Down defeated. If God been good to you, lift your voice and lift your voice and say, glory. Help you out of me. He woke us up. Early. This morning. Put bread on my table. Clothes on my back. Gave me a reasonable portion of my health and my strength. I could have been. Y'all ain't talking back to me. My sheets could have been my wine and dry. But God been good to me. The Bible said that the redeemed of the Lord. I want to say so. You ought to tell somebody, I'm glad. Got to be born again. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Look at some. come out to bitch your ass. The world will give it to me. Surely it came. Take it away. God bless you. And may God keep you. It could have been. It could have been. It could have been me. Now let me go ahead and tell the truth. It was me. It was me. But thank God he's a forgiving God. Thank God there's somebody praying for me. When I didn't have sense enough to pray for myself, somebody prayed for me. Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. God bless you.
The word of God has been preached. If there's someone in the house that don't know Jesus in the heart of your soul, you're not saved.
Oh, I am.
All right. I'm not trying to get anybody to join the church right now. But if you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you just joined the church. I'm not talking about a denomination. I'm talking about the church. You become a part of the body of baptized believers. If you're in the house and you haven't trusted him as your Lord and Savior, will you come?
Ooh.
Just thank you, Lord. Thank you for the word. Thank you for the preacher. Thank you for the soul that just came. Lord, we just thank you. It's in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Gordon congregation, okay, we have M.L. Walker, who's coming under Christian Experience.
All right.
To join New Bethel Baptist Church.
All right. Sure. All
right. Thank you all. I just want to say, over about 60 years ago, or maybe a little better, I was baptized at this church right here.
All right.
And somehow or another, I wound up back here years later. It's been a long time, but you know, when God puts you somewhere, you don't have anything to do about it.
So right.
You just follow His instructions.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So it's been a long time.
All right.
But I'm back.
All right.
Praise God.
Yeah.
You know, maybe the other churches, they vote you in.
No.
All right.
If you're saved.
Top!
Right. That's right.
You already.
That's right.
We'll put you on the phone here. I'm going to make you a promise.
Yeah.
People going to talk about you.
But me and my brother, we talk about each other. That's what family do.
Go.
And I promise you another thing. I love you.
Lord,
and they'll love you too.
Yeah.
Welcome home.
Welcome.
He's been telling me for a few weeks now that he's just trying to tie up some ends at another church.
All right.
Coming home. So I feel like break dancing.
I have bad knees.
I know what you're doing. Yes, sir. Knees and your joy.
We go to fellowship again. Sunday morning.
Okay. Yes, sir. The Lord's church, I'll be here.
You're already a part. You're covered, bro.
Yeah.
That's right. You're covered. We got you. We love you. Amen.
Amen.
Church Sunday. I mean, what's going on with that? Monday evening. Came in and everybody was sitting. A few pews back. And I didn't know him at all. I knew it was Bud. Bud was sitting on the Amen pew. And everybody else sitting back. And I said, but the reason we asked y'all to leave those seats vacant. Just joking. But it was a vacancy right there. It finally filled in, but it wasn't a vacancy right there.
Yeah.
But I want to thank the pastor you for these 3 nights.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
A word teaching.
Yes, sir.
So many churches have gotten away from the world.
Yes, sir. Right. True.
Just teaching stuff.
Sure.
Something to take it fast.
That's right.
Take a praise break. It's time to stop taking breaks.
That's right.
This is Jesus.
Yeah. Yes.
So I thank Pastor Newton.
Amen.
It was
amazing the way that the Lord set this up for him to be here.
Yes, sir.
And thank him for the availability. But I also want to thank New Bethel.
All right now.
For coming home to your own church. Because the revival is for New Bethel. We want our friends to be here.
Amen.
But the revival is for New Bethel. I thank New Bethel for showing up. Now, before y'all go, it's some fish in the bag. They want to feed folks. I'm glad I came tonight. Fish. But thank you, ushers. Y'all went over the folks, everybody. The musicians, the choirs. Everybody fell in line. The deacon staff did their job. And Brother Jackson, he didn't let illness stop him from working Monday. So for the past few years, the revival would start on Monday night, and I have to do the pulpit devotion by myself. But he did it by himself. He said, I got it, Pastor. He has been some kind of blessing. Yeah, no doubt. I tell you, when I get out on my knees, I pray for Pastor Jackson,
yes,
Sister Jackson.
Yes.
Amen. Pray for everybody. Pray.
Yes.
See, I mentioned them by name.
Yes.
Are there any announcements? I'm going to let these preachers
so good to be here, Pastor. Remind everyone Saturday morning,
New Bethel going to the Black History Museum. Saturday morning, they're leaving at what time?
8:30.
Okay, I just need to show up and tell them to, man. Here at 8:30. Catch the vans to Jackson. So, now, my dear friend. Pastor Newton, we're gonna let him come back up and pray over that grill. I mean that food. But have his words. I just want to thank you again, Pastor. Thank you. I'm glad you found your way up the street. Now we're gonna keep you up the street. God bless you.
Amen. God bless you. And continue to keep you in our prayer. Amen. Let us stand. Series of revival services. We thank you for what our eyes have seen and for what our ears have heard. I pray, O God, that you will continue to bless this place, the Bethel Church, and these congregants, Lord, that have gathered all week long. I prayers and the revival will live on.
Yes.
That it will be exemplified in their lives.
Yes.
Strengthen them where they're rebuild them up where they're torn down. God, we even thank you for this pastor.
Yes,
you bless all of his leaders. Keep them in your care. Now, Lord, we want to thank you for the food that has been prepared for the nourishment of our physical bodies. Bless those that have labored in the preparation of the food. Bless those that were recipients in the fellowship. Now may the grace of our Lord, the love of Jesus, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, may it rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth, now, and forever. And all of us would sing together.
Oh.